Monkey Wrench Mike just got a hold of me, said he got T-boned somewhere on exit 6. I don't even know where exit 6 is. I have no idea what highway he's stuck on. Hello? Hey, where are you exactly? Oh, you got to be kidding me. That's that dance they do on what's that game? What's that video game with? Yeah. He doesn't like root beer floats.
Yeah. Uh-uh.
That's un-American. That's all I'm going to say. It's un-American.
Says the man with the red cap.
Uh-oh. Okay. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Auto Auction Rebuilds. Today, we're kind of doing a little test run with the BMW i8. Sort of. We've agreed to deliver the Nissan Altima all the way to Dallas, Texas, to a dealership that already purchased it from me. So Monkey Wrench Mike is here, and look what he brought. He brought the S550.
Ta-da!
This is an S550, right?
No. Right here, dude.
Oh, those aren't fake badges? You sure?
I bought it from you.
It's probably fake,
you get these
then.
On eBay and then
yep.
Stick them on there?
Yep.
Great, thanks.
Well, she's looking clean, man.
Well, I washed it yesterday.
So, how many things have gone wrong with it since you bought it? Really?
Uh-huh.
I almost think I should have. Ooh. Ooh, that's gnarly. That's gnarly.
Okay, I got this like 2 days after I got the car.
But
I've been driving her. I've been to Oklahoma City 3 or 4 times. Been to Bartlesville.
Oh, wow.
Came down here to Midwest City.
Huh.
Yeah.
I was sure it was going to blow up on me.
Shh, don't listen to him. Don't listen to him.
Hey, if you guys don't know who Monkey Wrench Mike is, I think most of you do by now. But if you don't, go check out his channel. I'll have a link down in the description below. Definitely go follow him because he has this beautiful... This isn't the only beautiful car you got. He's got a lot of really, really nice cars. But this, I think, is his flagship.
This is the newest.
Yeah.
Nicest.
Yeah, it's too much of a grandpa car for me. It's an old person's car, you know. For me, I'm a young buck. All right, us younger guys, we're with the next generation. We're into that futuristic, technological stuff, right? So this is what 21st century men drive. This is what 19th century men drive.
19th century.
I'm just playing. Yeah. I'm just playing. But we are about to get on the road, and we're going to take this on our first test run all the way to Dallas. And I'm going to attempt to make it all the way there without charging and without getting gas. That's, do you know how many miles it is down there from here?
I didn't look. It's like 3 hours, isn't it?
Something like that. So 100 and something, 60.
You didn't do the math.
No.
You're making me drive this electric car
yeah.
with this much range
yeah.
and going this far?
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, I really didn't. I really should have done. But Monkey Wrench Mike is going to be driving this. So I think what you're going to want to do is definitely go subscribe to his channel. Are you doing a video on this?
Yeah.
Surely you're doing a video. Okay, good. He's going to do a video on this, guys. So definitely go follow his channel so you can see his, you know, his honest first impressions, because I won't be in the car with him. So he'll be able to say whatever he wants to say without.
So
what
I brought
is that?
This so we can charge the battery in case we run out of battery. Will this work or no?
For the i3?
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to charge that battery, man. I mean, the i8. It's an i8. It's just disguised as an i3. Yeah, so go follow Monkey Wrench Mike. He's going to be the first one to take this on a trip. And he'll be able to tell you what his first impressions, thoughts are. You know, is it comfortable? Does it suck? How's the range? I honestly don't know. He's going to find out because I'm driving a traditional gasoline car. So I guess if you run out of electricity, you can flash your... Well, you won't have electricity for the lights.
How do I flash? If
I guess. Oh! Oh! Instead of helping, I'm recording. Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
Got
you got something?
Yeah. I got donuts and I got... I'm like a grandma. With
look, in here, it's
right
about
here.
To do it again.
Okay, there we go. See, I got everything in here. Look at that. Never happened.
Yeah, looks Ta-da. Good as new. In fact, I think that may have added some shine to it.
Yeah, she needs a wax.
Wow. You should do a little bit more, man. We could wax it with coffee before you get out of here. All right, guys. We're going to go pick up the Altima, and we're going to make a trip down to Dallas, go meet a fellow subscriber who is subscribed to Monkey Wrench, Mike, and myself. He's excited to meet us. We're excited to meet him. We're going to drop his car off to him, and we're going to see how this thing does all the way to Dallas and back. All right, so Mike just got in and he's laughing. That's never.
It's so little.
That's never a good sign. Thanks. Boy, what a way to emasculate a guy, right? It's so little. Okay. So to start out, guys, I want to show you. We've got a... To start it, Mike, just so you know how to turn it on and off. There's the start button is there.
Okay.
And listen very carefully. That's a fake noise. That's not even real. That's fake. It's artificial. So that you know it's running.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
All right. We've got 118 miles of battery range. Mm-hmm. We've got 67 miles of gas range for a total of 185. But there's a button down here, Eco Pro. Mm-hmm. You put it into Eco Pro, you get 210 miles of range. Eco Pro Plus, you get 215. I don't recommend that. It limits you to like 56 miles an hour and no climate control.
Okay.
So Eco Pro, 210 miles is what it says we're going to get. So let's find out.
210 miles. Can I show you this?
Oh, no.
Dallas is 213 miles. And that's just regular Dallas. Are we going to make it?
Awkward silence. Well.
Okay.
This is a true problem, isn't it? Okay.
No, because you still have the gas, right? Well, that, or is that, well, that's total?
Yeah, that's total.
Okay.
Yeah, 185, or if you put it in Eco Pro, 208, but it limits you to 70 miles an hour.
Okay.
Oh.
Well, this is going to be an excellent adventure then.
Yeah, okay. The shifter, it's like handshaking. Forward is drive, and all the way backwards is reverse. Park is on top there.
Okay.
Very strange.
That is the worst thing I've ever seen. Oh, and it's cool. And she'll go.
Yeah.
Oh, it's not a Tesla, but
no, it's not a Tesla. Definitely not a Tesla. But yeah, she'll move. Of course, that's, I'm totally killing our range by doing that, which we really don't have enough to begin with. So, yeah. So
I shouldn't plug in my phone to charge it. Will that?
Yeah, your phone will definitely make it to where you won't make the trip. No, you'll be fine. You can plug in your phone. I've got an iPhone charger in here.
Oh, wait, is that me? Because my seatbelt's
on? Yeah, it's fine. We're just going two blocks away to my shop. Leaving my house, and I'm driving two blocks to my shop, which is on the back side of my house. All right, guys, we're going to get on the road. Let's, I honestly don't know if we're going to make it. I don't. All right, guys, here we go. In the beautiful cleaned up Nissan Altima. Man, she really did come out nice. This car came out so nice. So nice. Fires right up. And wow, look at the water spots on this, man. Wow, this car was clean. I guess it rained. That sucks. I hate bringing it to the guy like this, but okay. Here it is. We are on our way. Okay, we've made our first pit stop. The i3 needs a little bit of juice. We've driven 52 miles, averaging 31 miles a gallon in the Altima. And let's go talk to Monkey Wrench Mike. And let's see how he's doing over here. What's the problem, man?
I thought it was your car.
What's going on? I'm going, and you're like running out of...
Oh, I'm still in gear. I hit park, didn't I?
Yeah, you're in park.
Okay. Stop.
Now, one of the problems you run into when you're doing this is you come to a charging station and find that it doesn't work. And I see a lot of these have bags over them. Hopefully, this one is good. It looks like this one is going to be all right. So we're going to try to put this charger on. It'll only take a few minutes, guys. I doubt we'll be here more than 15 minutes, and we'll be right back on the road. Well, we used plug share, and nothing here works. None. What a giant pile of crap this is. And quite literally, there's one, a steaming pile of crap right here, man. So this is our first experience. This is like a precursor to California.
Yeah.
This.
Do we have a date yet for that? Are we leaving or?
Yeah, we're leaving. You said your day off is the 11th, right?
11th, 12th, yeah. Okay.
I mean, we could take the truck.
Yeah, but what fun is that?
That's kind of where I'm at too. That wouldn't be any fun. And where's the content? We drove a truck to California. Yeah. Probably be the only truck in California.
True.
But guys, we're gonna have to figure something else out. What's the range left on this?
135, 139 or something.
And we've got 170?
Yeah. So we'll just have to get gas.
Yeah, how much electricity is left?
85% or something like that. 85
85 miles?
Something.
85 miles?
Here, you know this thing. Sit in there and look at it. This little thing is fun right here. This, when you hit the gas and it goes up and down like a keyboard, it's cool.
Yeah, when you let off the gas, it slows down real quick.
That is so bizarre.
So you've got, you kind of got to treat it like a brake pedal. You let off slowly and you slow down. It takes a while to get used to.
But it's quiet.
Yeah.
The whole car's quiet.
All right, guys. We'll figure this out. Minor setback. All right, we made it to another charger. Mr. Monkey Wrench Mike is parking. It looks like these work. Please, no, that one doesn't work. Looks like it's got to be this one. This one right here. All right, we finally found one that works. There we go. All right. Let's give her some electric. There we go. That should make her happy. All right, we should be able to hold this like right there. Authorizing payment. No account found. What? All right, sounds like she's ramping up. Hopefully it's gonna work. Please work. Boy, that wind is bad today. Look at that. There we go. There we go.
Charging?
Yes!
Yay!
All right, approximately 18 minutes later, the car is 88% full. We should have no problems getting the rest of the way. So let's get back on the road. We are running late meeting this guy. So we're rolling through Turner Falls, which is it's actually a beautiful little place with mountains in Oklahoma. These are the Arbuckle Mountains. They're not really mountains. They're small hills, I guess. One thing I'm concerned about is I'm looking in my rearview mirror. I do not see Monkey Wrench Mike anymore. I actually haven't seen him in a while. I hope he's doing all right. Yeah. Yeah, he's not back there. I don't see him. I haven't heard from him. We are in the Altima cruising at a nice 72-ish miles an hour. The Altima is doing great. Great fuel economy, 28.6 miles a gallon. We still have a long way to go before Dallas, and we are 3 hours late. So to the gentleman that we're on our way to meet, my sincerest apologies. He drove from Austin up to Dallas, so a 2.5 hour drive for him, and we are running so far behind. My goal right now is I got to get this Nissan Altima down there, and hopefully Monkey Wrench Mike is okay. I'm assuming if something was wrong, Monkey Wrench Mike would have let me know. So maybe he's having problems with the car because of the heavy winds. Maybe he's having to keep his speed down because the winds are pushing the car too hard around the road. It is a small car, and the winds today are absolutely insane. Now, on the plus side, coming back from Dallas, hopefully the winds will be pushing us on our way back home. So hopefully the economy of the vehicle, the i3 that is, will increase on the way back. But for now, let's try to get the rest of the way to Dallas. Let's hand this man his car, and I'm probably gonna have to, I think I got a few hundred dollars on me. I'll probably just hand him some of his money back as an apology. I know time is money, time is valuable, so I really do feel bad. Just a lot of unforeseen things going on today, including these ridiculous slowdowns on the highway. I cannot believe there's this much construction in such a short stretch of I-35 from Oklahoma City. We haven't even made it to Texas yet, and we have been slowed down to a dang near stop 4 times since we left Oklahoma City. Anyway, guys, let's get to Dallas, and let's meet this gentleman who's picking up the Altima and giving it a new home. Well, guys, we are getting closer. We're pretty close to Denton, Texas right now, and traffic seems to be flowing pretty smoothly finally. It's like you get out of Oklahoma, traffic finally starts acting right. I still have not heard from Monkey Wrench Mike. I still don't see him anywhere in my rearview at all. I'm assuming he's all right. because I haven't heard from him, and I would think if he wasn't all right, I probably would have heard something by now. So this will be interesting. By now, him and I are probably miles and miles apart from each other. I'm real curious to see, number one, if he's going to make it okay to the destination, to the drop-off point. And number two, what his experience was on the way down here, and if the wind was blowing him all over the place, I guess. That's what I'm most concerned about, is that the wind is the reason why he's had to slow it down. Anyway, the gentleman that we're meeting, by the time we get there or the time I get there, will have been waiting for 3 hours for me. 3 hours. It's unacceptable. It's unacceptable. I feel bad. I don't do that to people. Unfortunately, it's just been one series of unfortunate events after another, I guess. A lot of things have just not been working in our favor today. But we should be there within an hour. We will be there, guys, and we'll just see how this goes when we arrive. Well, I just heard from Monkey Wrench Mike. We've got 59 miles left until we reach Dallas. And he let me know that the battery has emptied, and we are now running on the backup generator to keep the battery at 5%. It looks like he's got about 70 miles of fuel available, and we have 60 miles before we reach our charging point. So this could be very, very interesting. We are literally going to make it by the skin of our teeth, assuming the car has taken into consideration these horrible, horrible winds which we are still facing down here in Dallas. Otherwise, that mileage could be reduced drastically. So stick with us, guys. This is getting exciting. All right, guys, something pretty serious just happened. I am so lost and stuck in traffic. Dallas, man, the people out here, look, nothing against Dallas, but these people drive like they're crazy, man. I've almost been in two accidents myself. The whole trip, fine, except for Dallas, and it's just nuts out here. Now, Monkey Wrench Mike just got a hold of me, said he got T-boned somewhere on exit 6. I don't even know where exit 6 is. I have no idea what highway he's stuck on. He hasn't answered back to tell me if he's okay or not. I'm assuming since he's texting, I'm assuming he's all right. I asked him to send me his GPS coordinates. I'm about to meet up with the guy that's purchasing this car because I'm already here. He's literally right in front of me. He's been waiting with traffic. I can't get back to Mike. I don't even know where Mike is. So Mike is going to have to send me his GPS coordinates, and I'm going to try to, I don't even know what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to turn around and get back. My main concern is that he's all right, and he has not texted back yet. So I'm going to park the car, get out of traffic, and I'm going to call Mike and make sure he's okay. That's priority one. Hey, where are you at? Hello? Hey, where are you exactly? Oh, you got to be kidding me. I'm here with this guy. He's ready to help figure out how to get... Oh, dude. I'm recording this, by the way. I'm recording this.
Why, we know.
All right, Grandpa. I'll see you when you get here. All right, bye.
Mr. Randy, how's it going, man?
So, Monkey Wrench Mike lied to me. He was not in a wreck. My heart's pounding out. I'm beating on my microphone. My heart's pounding out of my chest. I'm like, where is he? How am I even going to get back to him? And he lied to me. He's laughing. He's just,
That's what I said. When you said that, I'm like, hopefully he's kidding.
Well, I almost got sideswiped too. Like, the whole trip has been fine except for Dallas. As soon as we get to Dallas, people are just all over the place, man.
I know.
I want to introduce you to these folks here. This is
Joe.
Joe, nice to meet you. What's your name?
Matthew.
It's good
John
to meet you.
Collins.
Huh?
Matthew John Collins.
Oh yeah, John Collins. Hi, nice to meet you.
Matthew.
Very good.
John Collins.
Matthew John. I am so sorry
that
I have left you guys. Hello.
My daughter is running around there with her boyfriend. Walking around here. And they lost. I don't know where they're at.
I sincerely apologize for...
Yeah, I know how it is.
Well, it shouldn't happen like this. This was a series of serious unfortunate events happened today. My plumber came this morning for the frozen pipes on my fish pond. And... Yeah, which no big deal. He can do that on his own. I don't have to be there for that. He showed up at 9, he left, and I saw when I went out back, the pond was running. And I was like, okay, he fixed it. I get out there and the pond's empty. Like, it's only got this much water in it. And the water is backed up because leaves and debris have plugged up the little stream.
Right.
So I had to get out there and dig it out. And then the car, I think he's going to make it. I still don't know for sure if he's going to make it all the way. He said he had like 10 miles to spare. And that's if the car didn't...
So he couldn't put gas in it? It wouldn't take gas?
Well, we filled it up with gas, and then we had to charge it. The first chargers were broken, all of them. It was a big charge. Every single one was out of order. So then we had to go find another one, and we had to top it up, and then 8 minutes in, it kicked it out and said, unplug your car and move. And then we plugged it in again, and it gave us a little more, and I told him, I said, you have just enough to get here. If not, we'll have to figure it out. So it's been a...
We'll hold off a little bit if he gets stuck. We got him.
It has been a heck of a trip. And I know he's probably not too happy himself. He has to be up at 3 o'clock in the morning to go to work.
Wow.
Yeah. And he lives in Tulsa.
Yeah.
So he's got
to
drive.
He's close to you, right? Then he moved away, didn't he, or something like that?
Yeah, I live in the city. I live in Oklahoma City.
Right.
He lives in Tulsa, so he's got an even further... drive back than I do. This is kind of a test trip to see how the electric car is gonna do when this big trip to California.
Yeah.
And so far him and I both we're gonna do it anyway, but we're not too excited about it.
Did I get you?
Well, this is awkward.
Did I get you?
I yeah.
When you're in the sun, I gotta get your reaction.
Yeah.
There he
reaction
is.
Was
Did you tell him what happened?
Oh, yeah, I told him what happened. I was recording the whole time just in case you might be screwing with me.
Uh-huh.
But I felt like you weren't because I checked the status of the car to see if you were lying.
Yeah.
The car wouldn't respond to me.
Oh, the car. What do you mean respond?
To my phone.
Really?
It hasn't checked in since 1 o'clock this afternoon. So I was like, oh, my God, he must have got hit so hard that it knocked the batteries out of it or something, you know? Yeah.
Hopefully he's kidding with that. I'm like, that was just like, they're 5 minutes away. People?
I know. I was like, no, man.
That
but
made my whole day.
He said he had a trailer. He's like, hey, worst case scenario, I got a trailer over here.
Yeah, I got you.
What a nice guy.
Yeah, what a nice guy.
So anyway,
he's been sitting
on my stayback nice as hell, guys, right? Trust me.
Payback for what?
Oh, all the grief you've given me. Hey, buddy.
Oh, yeah, he's wanting to meet you. He watches our channels too, huh?
Yay,
yeah.
Matthew.
Yeah.
My name is Mike. Nice to meet you there, buddy.
He has a YouTube too, buddy.
Oh, he's gonna pause.
I don't know what that is.
That's that dance they do on what's that game? What's that video game with? Yeah, he's good at Fortnite. Yeah. He's good at it too. You just might come YouTube famous, man. You might just be YouTube famous.
Yeah.
All right, guys. There it goes. It's gone. Yep. And we now have full battery. So we've got 125 miles on battery and no miles on range extender. So we're going to have to go to a gas station. It feels weird saying that in an electric car. We got to go to a gas station and put some old petrol in this thing and see if we can survive getting out of Dallas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Since you got T-boned.
Yeah, since I got T-boned.
Yeah. Let's.
I fixed it real quick, so.
Let's get out of Dallas. Well, guys, we have made it. Do you know where we are?
Davis, Oklahoma.
Oh, we are in Davis.
I think, right? Isn't that?
I have no idea. I'm just the driver, man.
No, we're
not.
We're outside of Davis.
Okay.
We're near Davis.
We're near Davis, Davis-ish. Oklahoma. Davis-ish. And there she is.
We're north of the Arbuckles.
We passed the Arbuckles already.
Yeah.
Did we? I didn't see them.
Well, you were driving so fast.
Tell them how fast I was going.
85. in an EV.
And we made it all the way here from Dallas.
Yeah.
And we haven't gotten a charge, gas, or anything since we left. We've had no issues.
Because there's no wind.
Yeah, no wind. Like, coming up here was smooth sailing, guys. So the battery's completely depleted at this point. But the gasoline was still full. So we just rolled in here on the electric generator that runs off of fuel. We made it, and it's already 10%. When we got here, it was at 5. We've been plugged in for 2 minutes. We've gained 5% in 2 minutes.
This changes from yellow to blue.
Yeah, yellow says it's ready.
Yeah.
Blue says charging. It's charging. Green means it's done. Oh. Red means stop. It even has a little, look at this. It's got a little code for you right here.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah. Well, guys, honestly, I have been going fast without realizing it. I've been going 80, 85 miles an hour, not even realizing it. In this little bitty car, it will go 85 all day, and we've gotten pretty dang good range out of it. So we're here at A&W for a root beer. A root beer float for Monkey Wrench Mike. He doesn't like root beer floats.
Yeah, uh-uh.
That's un-American. That's all I'm going to say. It's un-American.
Says the man with the red cap.
Uh-oh. Okay. Oh. Ooh.
We've
avoided
politics.
That red cap is Phillips 66. That's American. Okay?
Yeah. Okay.
What wet red cap wearing American would drive an EV? Tell me that.
Exactly.
I am a chameleon. I fit in everywhere.
So we like the car,
yeah.
But tell them about the voice.
Oh, the GPS voice is you said it best. Like, it sounds like it's talking down.
Talking down to us.
Yeah.
Like we're kindergartners.
Yes. Yeah. It's like I'm better than you, and you don't know what you're doing, and do as I tell you.
And do it legally.
Yes, do it legally.
Make a legal U-turn.
Legal, it says this 100,000 times, man. When possible, make a legal U-turn. I should have recorded that so people could have really...
Yeah, well, we can do that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, let's go the wrong way on a one-way. And I'm sure it'll tell us to quickly make a legal U-turn.
We'll wait for this guy to go away.
Yeah, we do have some 5-0s right there. So we're getting back. This trip took far longer than anticipated.
And you wanted to go from Dallas to Wichita,
yeah,
and then come back.
I forgot about that.
In a day.
Yeah, Watch JR Go invited me up to Wichita to go hang out with him while he's working on a Pontiac Aztec. And I thought, well, you and I are going to be down here in Dallas, so we could just jump from Dallas up to Wichita, go hang out.
Away.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I may, you know, I had to let JR, I was like, man, we'll have to do another time. Because this is not possible. And it's already late, and he's got to be up at 2?
2 in the morning.
You can set your alarm for 3.
I'm about to be at work at 3:30.
It's okay, so 3.
So, I'm going to get home at midnight.
Oh, my.
Or 1.
Something. No.
Well, depending on how long this takes.
Tulsa. Yeah. Oh, my God, Tulsa. Yeah. You live in Tulsa.
His face.
I don't know why I was thinking we're almost back to the city. It's not
You're
that much.
Back.
Yeah, it's. No, it's Lord have
I've
mercy.
I've gone to work with less sleep. I've gone to work with no sleep.
Well, I feel bad. I really do. Yeah, man. Dang. I don't
this
know.
This is fun though. This is how much fun.
Oh, it's not gonna be fun when you wake up with 2 hours of sleep. You're gonna be in a really bad mood.
I've done that.
Well, so far we've experienced the car on a road trip. By the time we get back to the house, it'll have been surely over 400 miles. Yeah, easily over 400 miles round trip. And although the way down was a little rocky, the way back has been smooth sailing. Like, smooth sailing. So I think if you plan it just right, keep an extra gas can in the car, and drive reasonably, not 85.
Right.
I think you could do a road trip
just
in this.
Plan out where these things are.
And hope they work.
And hope they work.
And hope...
A lot of them don't.
But thankfully, you do have that gasoline that'll
That's
get you.
A game changer. That really is a game changer.
Yeah. Just in case the chargers don't work, just put a little... Look, we're at a gas station, so you can put a little more gas in it. If the chargers don't work, get you to the next charging station. And as you can see, we've been here 6 minutes now. We're now at 21%. So it charges relatively quickly.
Yeah. That looks like the radio display of my S55. With those burned out...
Yeah. It's got this. They look like sunspots. They look like sunspots. Look at that. Yeah. Hey, I'm just glad the thing works, man. I'm glad.
And the sound.
Yeah, it sounds like a jet. Woo! Yeah, so big shout out to who is this, Francis EV Charging, for like half the time not working or shutting off when you're in the middle of charging and leaving you stuck to have to unplug it, plug it in, and pay again to do it again. So yeah, big shout out to these. Hopefully this is not the experience when we start heading towards the west coast. I can't remember what direction. Going west. Okay guys, I'm gonna let this charge. We're gonna go inside and get a root beer float, and then we're gonna get back on the road. Well guys, we made it back. It was a 435 mile trip. We made it back with 73 miles of gasoline because we hardly used it. We hardly used gas at all, and we still have 8 miles left on our battery. So really the only thing left to do is to shut it down and let's go put some juice in it, man. So the trip was a complete success. It was a lot of fun. Monkey Ranch Mike and I had a great time spending several hours together driving through Dallas traffic, which let me tell you was absolutely no fun. But I can tell you this, the car, for as small as it is, it's actually very roomy inside, and I was very comfortable. I still feel fine. Like my back isn't hurting, my legs aren't sore. Very comfortable little car. And yes, it can keep up 75, 80, 85 miles an hour on the interstate with no problem. And thus far, finding a place to charge has been very, very easy. It's been no problem finding a place to charge the car, even when you find out the charger's broken and you have to go somewhere else. No big deal. The gas part of the car can carry you through to the next charger. It didn't take a whole lot longer than if we had been driving a straight gas car. So even though this is just a preliminary, a very preliminary thought on the car, or set of thoughts on the car, I should say, so far I'm very impressed, and I'm looking forward to this coming week taking this car all the way out to North Hollywood, Los Angeles, and seeing how it does on a real road trip. So do me a favor, guys. If you enjoyed the content, hit the thumbs up button. Don't forget to follow Monkey Wrench Mike down below, because he's going to have his own review of the car. I don't know what he's going to say. I don't know what his opinions are. So I'm going to be very interested to see if his opinions match mine, or, you know, if he's got a few different opinions than I do when it comes to what this car was like to drive all the way to Dallas and back. So definitely go check out Monkey Wrench Mike on YouTube. Links down below. Subscribe to both of our channels. We would both appreciate it. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the content. And stay safe out there, guys. I will catch you all. I'm going to bed. So I'm going to catch you all very, very soon in the next one.